I'm Krista Seiden. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to use Google Analytics reports to learn about your e-commerce business. E-commerce refers to businesses that sell products or services online. So if your website sells goods or services that people can purchase from you online, then this video can help you learn more about their purchasing behavior and how your different products are performing. Three quick things before we get started. This video is part of a series all about reporting in Google Analytics. Together, we're looking at how to find answers to your basic questions about how people are finding and interacting with your website or app. We'll link the full playlist below for you. Second, this video, as part of the series, is focused specifically on reporting. If you're looking for information about how to set up e-commerce events and dimensions for your property, we'll link tutorials for setup below. Third, if you haven't already, you can access the Analytics demo account to follow along with me today. I'll be showing you e-commerce data from a real Google Analytics account for the Google Merchandise Store. If you want to look at the same data, go to the URL here, also found in the video's description, to follow along with me in the demo account, or also look at the same reports in your own property. With that, let's dive into the Google Merchandise Store property. First, let's briefly walk through the reports available in the monetization section and what you might want to use them for. The overview report is similar to other overview reports in GA, with several cards detailing high-level metrics such as total revenue and total purchasers. The e-commerce purchases report is where you'll want to dig into details of the items you're selling on your site. You can look at things like item name, item brand, item ID, which is also commonly the item SKU, and more across metrics like views, add to carts, purchases, and revenue. If you want to know the answer to the question, what are my best performing products? This is where you'd want to go. Let's look at that together. So for the Google Merchandise Store, if I scroll down here, it looks like the Super G Timbuktu Recycled Backpack is our most viewed product. Is it our best performing? Well, that depends on what performance means to you, but in terms of the Google Merchandise Store, often that might mean revenue. So let's go ahead and sort this column by item revenue over here on the right.
And when we do that, we now see that our top performing item by revenue is the Super G Brick Puzzle Set, and we've sold 152 of them for total item revenue of $6,064.
You can also zoom out and look at things like top categories. So if we click here in this dropdown, you'll see not only do we have item name, which is what we're looking at now, item ID is going to be that SKU level information, item category is something that you might be interested in analyzing. Here we see, still sorted on revenue, that apparel is going to be our most performing category, followed by things like new products and shopping by brand. And again, if we want to see not just by revenue, but maybe items viewed, we can resort by that column and see actually we're getting a lot of views on new items, even though that's not the highest revenue. This is a great way to do analysis on your e-commerce store to see how your products are performing. Next, we have the Purchase Journey Report. The Purchase Journey Report looks at the customer journey from session start all the way through purchase, so you can understand the progression from arriving on the site to viewing your product to adding to cart and beginning checkout. This can help you answer questions like, where is the drop-off on my site for users who are going through my purchase journey? In this case, it looks like for the Google Merchandise Store, a lot of people are starting their sessions, viewing products, adding to cart, but not checking out. So maybe there's something that could be optimized in that add to cart flow. This funnel report also breaks down this data by a number of dimensions. For example, if we wanted to know how mobile versus desktop users progress through the purchase journey on the Google Merchandise Store, we can use this report to see that while mobile actually has more sessions, as we can see here, users on desktop add to cart at a much higher rate. You can see drop off from each step to learn where users are abandoning their cart and also potentially act on it. In another example, if you want to create an audience of people who added to their cart and then abandoned, that is actually something that you can do in Analytics with a similar report in the Explore section. We'll link some resources on those steps in the description below. There's also a Checkout Journey Report that looks a lot like the Purchase Journey Report, but it's more granular and includes information like shipping and payment information. This would be the report to look at if you want to understand if users are dropping off at a certain point in your checkout process, such as adding shipping info or adding payment info. The in-app purchases and publisher ad reports are specific to mobile apps, and we'll show you how many in-app purchases the app is driving and how mobile ads are performing. The last report in this section is the promotions report. And this is where you'd go if you want to answer questions about how your promotions on site are performing. So here we have various promotions listed by their promo names, such as Aloha and Calling All YouTube Fans. And we can see how many items were viewed in that promotion, as well as how many items were clicked in that promotion and the click-through rate. So this is great information to know if the promos that we're showing on our site are actually working and leading to clicks and purchases. And that's it for today. Now you can use analytics reports to answer some of the most common questions that online businesses have about their e-commerce performance. In the description below, we'll link resources to learn even more about the e-commerce setup and reporting. Join us back here in the next video to cover common troubleshooting questions you might have when looking at analytics reports. Until then, happy measuring.